money to keep themselves fed. What shall we do? What shall we do? Said the widow. One spring day, we don't have enough money to buy seed for the farm this year. We must sell our cow. Oh, pets, and with the money buy seed. Enough seed to plant a good crop. All right, mother, say that. It's market day today. I'll go into town and sell basil. So Jack took the cow's halter in his hand, walked through the garden gate and headed off toward town. He had gone far when he met a funny looking old man who said to him, "Good morning, Jack. Good morning to you," said Jack, wondering how the little old man knew his name. "Where are you off to this fine morning?" asked the man. "I'm going to market to sell our cow, Basie." "Well, what a helpful son you are," exclaimed the man. "I have a special deal for such a good boy like you." The little old man looked around to make sure no one was watching and then opened his hand to show Jack what he held. "Beans?" asked Jack, looking a little confused. "Three magical beans seem to be exact, young man. 1, 2, 3. So magical are they that if you plant them overnight, by morning they grow right up to the sky," promised the funny little man. "And because you are such a good boy, they are all yours in trade for that old milking cow." "Really?" said Zed. "And you are quite sure they are magical?" "I am indeed. And if it doesn't turn out to be true, you can have your cow back." He dug inside the kitchen and said, "I'm ready for my breakfast. I'm so hungry. I will eat 3 cups."
"Ah, what does I smell?"
"Fee, fi, fo, foom. I smell the blood of an Englishman. Be he alive or be he dead, I have his bones to drink my bread."
"Nonsense, dear," said he was. "We haven't had a boy for breakfast in years. Now you go and wash up, and by the time you come back, breakfast is ready for you." So the giant went off to tidy up. Jack was about to make a run for it when the woman stopped him.
"Wait until he is asleep," she said. "He always has a little snooze after breakfast." Jack peeped out of the copper pot just as the giant returned to the kitchen, carrying a basket filled with golden eggs and a sickly looking. When he, the giant, white him, the giant poked the hand and rolled, lay and the hand laid an egg made of gold, which the add to the basket. After his breakfast, the giant went to the closet and pulled out a golden harp with the face of sin. "Younger," the giant poked the harp and grow. "Play." And the harp began to play a gentle tune while her lovely face sung a lovely. Then the giant began to nod his head and to snore until the harp shook. When he was quite sure the giant was asleep, Jack crept out of the copper pot and began to tiptoe out of the kitchen, just as he was about to leave. He heard the sound of the kitchen. Whipping Jack's sickly hand and the singing harp, and began to tiptoe back out. But this time, the hand gave a tackle which woke up the giant, and just as Jack got out of the house, he heard him calling, Wife, what have you done with my husband with hand and my golden harp?" Jack ran as fast as he could, and the giant, releasing his bad bean tree, come rushing after, away from the castle and down the broad, winding road. When he got to the beanstalk, the giant was only 20 yards away when suddenly he saw Jack disappear underneath. Confused, the giant peered, dropped the cloth, and saw Jack underneath climbing down for their leap. The giant stopped his foot and roared angry, "Fee, fi, fo, foom. I smell the blood of an Englishman. Be he alive or be he a thief, I have his spoon to grind my bread." The giant swung himself down onto the big salt which shook with his weight. Jack slipped and slid and climbed down the beanstalk as quickly as he could, and after him climbed the giant. As he neared the button, Jack called out, "Mother, please hurry, bring me an axe, bring me an axe." And his mother came rushing out with Jack with cupping axe in her hand. But when she came to the enormous beanstalk, she stood still with fright. Jack jumped down, got hold of the axe, began to chop away at the beanstalk. Luckily, because of all the chores he'd done over the years, he'd become quite good at chopping, and it didn't take long for him to chop through enough of the beanstalk that it began to tatter. The giant left the beanstalk shake and quicker, so he stopped to see what was the matter. Then Jack gave one last big chop with the axe, and the beanstalk began to topple over. The sunshine. With a bit of patience and his mother's help, it didn't take long for Jack to get Sickly hand back in good health. And the grateful hen continued to play, lay and fresh golden egg every day. Jack used the money from selling the golden egg to buy back all Beth's perky seed for the spring crop and to feed his mother farm. He haven't had enough left